on 2K Sports. Some of our first look at what's in store for the league come regular season. Steve Kerr's by my side, as is Clark Kellogg. This is Kevin Harlan. Doris Burke is waiting in the wings on the sideline. It's the Sacramento Kings and the Phoenix Suns. And our State Farm starting lineups. Here's a look. And guys, what do you think we'll be seeing from Marcin Gortat in this one?
Well, the thing that I like about Gortat is how deceptive he is in the ways that he scores. I mean, he can score in transition. He can catch in the paint with either hand and finish. He can knock down a jump shot. I mean, he doesn't look like a star, but he's developing into one.
Yeah, you know what, Steve? He really is. He might not be the biggest guy, but Gortat thrives on contact. He can pack a punch, too. I've watched him many times. Just leaning into you and bumping into you and working your way down the floor. He can definitely wear a player down with all of them. Look at the Kings, still in the preseason. They look like they're finding an early rhythm. I know they hope to continue that throughout this long, long NBA season.
You know, Kevin, it's always important to have some kind of fruit for your labor. Winning games is that fruit. When you play well and you win, then you feel good about yourself. And it gives you confidence, and that confidence can be built on during the course of a long NBA season.
But now is really the time to start building it, guys, and that's where they've been doing it. It's been a sharp preseason for them to this point. So let's see if they can keep it going.
That one goes. Count it.
Well, you're not going to get a more high-quality look than that. Terrific offensive rebound there.
Jason Thompson out of Ryder. Nice rotation, big man, about 6'11", 250. I like his game. You know, when DeMarcus Cousins arrived in Sacramento, Thompson's minutes waned a little bit. I think he's got a lot of potential. Somebody could make a steal if they were able to make a move for him.
That's an unusual, surprising miss for him. Typically, he's good on those inside.
Let's catch up with Doris from the sideline.
Kevin, Pete Smart gave me a few minutes to catch up with him. We talked about some of the matchups he'll be watching in this game, and he told me, I'll be looking at how we deal with Marcin Gortat inside. He's a guy who can score in any number of ways, posting up, pulling up from outside, or rolling to the rim. And he's also a factor on the glass. Guys, Gortat might not be a household name, but he's an impact big man in the NBA, no question.
And thank you for that, Doris. Now here's Brooks. Defense is right there. Into Jason Thompson. Gortat with the block. Fast break, here come the Suns. Stolik kicks to Dragic. Gets it to go. And Thompson, 6'11", can give you minutes of power forward or center.
Yeah, I really like him. A well-rounded player. Not elite in any one category, but solid across the board in everything.
Now, here's Thornton. He picked up 15 points in their last win against the Lakers.
And Kevin, a lot of those points came at the line. So he was very aggressive with his game, attacking the D and capitalizing on those free throws.
Dragic kicks to Scola. And just under 2.5 minutes elapsed here in the first. Beasley, top of the key. Beasley can't get that one to fall.
Yeah, he struggled with his shot this quarter, and he's got to find a groove somehow. Alvin Gentry, one of the great guys in this league, so well-liked, and I think has developed into one of the better coaches in the league. Helped his team make that late playoff push last season.
Chuck Hayes, he's checked in for DeMarcus Cousins. The Suns trailing. They come into this one following a loss to the Thunder.
Well, they were lucky it wasn't a blowout, because they didn't put forth a very strong performance in that one.
Yeah, they just couldn't find anything to work for them, Steve, no matter.
Oh, man, that was unreal.
Mark it up. Man, oh, man, finishing with flavor.
Yeah, he put something extra on that one. You're right.
And the bench going wild, guys. They love it. What an amazing dunk.
Last outing for Sacramento, they won that game against the Lakers in Los Angeles.
And you look at the box score from that game, guys, and the first thing you notice is how many turnovers they forced.
Yeah, and one thing the box score doesn't show is just how many points came as a direct result of those turnovers. There were a whole bunch of them.
Shannon Brown is one of those guys who, when he gets in transition, you kind of hold your breath because you can't wait to see what's coming. He can absolutely fly. He's a guy who's on the highlight reel night after night.
And Shannon Brown, fellas, at 6'4", 210, powerfully built, athletic player. Big, strong hands. The one thing that I felt he needed to do was improve his ball handling, because if he did that, I really thought he could be an explosive scorer around the rim and on the perimeter.
Fournette dishes to Johnson. Robinson a screen on Brown. Six on the shot clock. Here's Njai. And he's knocked off course by the D. The foul called. He'll shoot free throws. They get Jermaine O'Neal.
Last season was the sixth straight, Kevin, where the Kings failed to make the playoffs. And really, they haven't been in postseason contention for any of those 6 years.
You're right, 6 years. But it seems much longer than that for some reason, doesn't it, for the Kings?
Mm-hmm.
They're so used to making the playoffs in the years leading up to this drought.
Well, prior to that, Kevin, they had made the playoffs eight consecutive years before this six-year drought. So, boy, it's been a strange run for Sacramento. Some ups and downs, and let's hope they can get this thing turned back in the right direction.
They get a hand on it. Now, here's Thomas. He's guarded by Dragic. Robinson sets a screen for Garcia. A three from Fredette. And that one's good. Fredette's got his first 3 points of the game.
You look back at the footage of Jimmer when he was playing at BYU, and I mean, he'd shoot threes from 6-7 feet behind the three-point line. So it's all about the shooting range and the offensive repertoire for Fredette. He's got a lot of potential.
Well, there aren't a whole lot of places where Jimmer isn't willing to pull up from. That trigger is quick to pull. If he gets in the zone, he'll pull up from a few feet beyond the arc. And I'm telling you what, it's fun to watch. The dish out to Garcia from outside the arc. And the officials call over the back. A little too aggressive there.
Obviously, he's not afraid of physical play, but he still needs to play in control.
And he definitely wasn't in control that time. Everybody in the building knew it was an over-the-back call.
All right, go, man.
First free throw is good. The Suns making a switch here. Prize checked in. And the Kings will go for a different look here. DeMarcus Cousins, he's checked in for Enda. Evans comes in for Francisco Garcia. Marcus Thornton, he's checked in for Jimmer Fredette. And it's Brooks in for Isaiah Thomas. About 3 seconds between shot and game clock. He feeds it to Cousins. It's hauled in by Fry. Suns have gone 50% from the field to this point, 4 of 8. Out of bounds, Sacramento takes possession. And the Suns making a change here. And here is Brooks. He had 16 points in the win against the Lakers in Los Angeles. And here's Thornton outside. Rebounded by Dudley. Here's Telfair, a miraculous buzzer beater.
Well, I love how he kept his cool there. Low stress, not a care in the world.
You're right.
Oh, man, with time running down, knowing that you need to...
And a high scoring first.